art known as Prabhat Prabhang. But in Thailand, if you go and you see Prabhat Prabhang, the Thais don't know what that is. That's like become a Western term. Fun Dab is what the Thais refer to it as. And that actually translates to long and short, representing the swords. Now, you won't see old depictions of Thai boxers, and they're riding elephants with spears. And everybody's like, that's not Thai boxing. No, that was Thai boxing at the time. But they didn't call it Muay Thai yet. They called it Prabhat Prabhang, which was based on swordplay. The Thais use that phrase, swordplay. Okay, and that is the art was originally based on weaponry. Very similar to the Kali, Silat, the Kali, the Eskrima. Okay, it's done with a stick, but it's really a translation of empty hand combat. So the Thais kind of followed a similar pattern, as a lot of Southeast Asian cultures did. Okay, the Thais were using swords, and little by little, they stopped riding elephants and smoking opium, killing Burmese, and they started learning Muay Thai. Okay, but before that happened, Prabhat Prabhang, aka Phan Dab, the ancient art on the battlefield, like that, the ancient art on the battlefield, okay, became known as, little by little, as what we call Muay Chaya, or Muay Bolan. And that's where you see the hemp rope. Now, contrary to Jean-Claude Van Damme movies, there was no glass, pine resin, but there was pine resin and crushed seashells, which is probably worse than glass, because you know how like seashells give you like that coral, so you scratch yourself on coral, your leg falls off and infects the leg. Seashells crushed and crushed up and wrapped in their hands. Okay? So this art was known as Muay Chaya or Muay Bolan. And it's basically bare knuckle boxing. What it was. But they did bound their fists, and depending on where the boxers were from, the north, the south, they wrapped it longer or shorter. And it's very similar to how camps have certain strategies or techniques, like, you know, some boxers maybe like to fight on the inside. You know, the guy that owns that gym is really, really good on the inside. So all his fighters are like that. Or maybe one guy has this Roy Jones shoulder roll, so all these guys kind of emulate that. Well, the ancient art had that as well. That's where it was derived. So some of the boxers wrap their hands or wrap their arms. If they like to block kicks and they were more punchers, they wrap longer. If they like to use their elbows, they wrap shorter so the elbow was exposed, etc., etc. This is still performed, actually, a couple times a year in the Kingdom of Thailand. We bring Burmese fighters to the kingdom, we have Muay Bolan fights. And it's great. It's awesome. It's a great fight to see. Okay? It's very exciting. It's not as brutal as you think it is, okay, because they're very skilled. If you put a couple of you guys in hemp ropes and let you guys go at it, it would not look like that. That's for sure. Okay, me included. Like I can't pull it off. Okay, so Muay Chaya or Muay Bolan, little by little, slowly translated to Mei Mai Muay Thai, which became the mastery techniques of Muay Bolan. So in other words, there were these great fighters, but what happened was all these kind of sick techniques kind of surfaced, and that was known as Mei Mai Muay Thai, which translates to the mastery techniques of the ancient art, Muay Bolan or Muay Chaya. At this point, the swords are gone, and we're civilized. Okay, we're not killing people. From there, from the mastery techniques of Mei Mai Muay Thai, became the modern art of what we know as Muay Thai. And roughly in the 1930s, rules were introduced to ensure the safety of the boxers, like coconut shells and worm protection. Okay? They didn't have mouthpieces, we didn't get that far yet. They put gloves on, so no more bare knuckles, okay? They put shorts on them, and they made it marketable, and Toyota put a pickup truck for a tournament prize, and they do that. They fight for pickup trucks, I'll say that. Okay? They fight for batteries. I seen a guy win at Monkey Stadium, he got handed a car battery, and I was like, I don't know. So, going back, Prabhat Prabhang, aka Phan Dab, long and short. Muay Chaya, Muay Bolan, the bound fist. Mei Mai Muay Thai, the mastery techniques of the ancient art, and then Muay Thai, modern Muay Thai, what we know of as today. Okay, now, as I mentioned before, one of the known specialties, or one of the things that the camp has become noted for, the Sika Tong camp and the Sika Tong legacy, is because we have been one of the few camps, and Sika Tong was one of the few masters from the old school that was able to preserve the Mei Mai Muay Thai techniques. Okay, and we narrowed it down to about 15 solid techniques. Now, a lot of them, again, are not necessarily applicable, or we can't pull them off. So I want to give you five Mei Mai Muay Thai techniques from the ancient art that you guys can actually pull off in practice. Okay? So we're gonna get gloves.